Dear students of class 10, today's lesson, the First World War, some points which I have mentioned in the board. As for these points, I am going to teach this lesson. First one, imperial and colonial aspirations. First point, imperial and colonial aspirations. You know, two countries of the world, France and Britain, had become financially very much powerful, politically, socially, culturally, they had become very powerful. Why? Because they established so many colonies throughout Europe, throughout different parts of the world. So in order to compete, their manufactured goods, they produced from their factories and industries and supplied it to different parts of the world. The other countries like Germany, Italy, they required the vast markets of, East Asia, the vast market of Far East, so that they could supply their raw materials for their factories and industries from there, and they could earn a lot of money like France and Britain. That's why Germany took initiative. Germany strengthened her, national prestige. Germany strengthened her security. As a result, Germany increased weapons. They started producing or making sophisticated weapons so that they could fight against their enemies and can establish a number of colonies throughout Far East, throughout East Asia. And besides, the building of the, besides France and Russia, both of them, France and Russia, both of the two countries of Europe, became very much aggressive in their nature on the question of establishing colonies or supplying their finished products in different parts of the world. Kaiser William II of Germany took an oath that he would establish his country in the field of honor, in the field of distinction. He was determined to establish his country, Germany, to be a very powerful one in front of the people of the world leaders, in front of the world leaders. That's why Kaiser William II, from the very, very beginning, they decided to make his country number one world power, and considered important causes for the First World War. Next one, the immediate causes of the First World War or Sarajevo crisis. Sarajevo crisis was one of the most important crises. It was a crisis related to Balkan issues. Sarajevo crisis means Archduke Francis Ferdinand, the heir to the Austrian throne, he visited Sarajevo in order to open bilateral discussions with the king. And next, suddenly he was assassinated along with his wife and children by a Serbian student. Sarajevo was a place of Serbia. One Serbian student suddenly killed him. Now why? Because the Serbia wanted to unite all Serbian people into a single Serbian state. So many Serbs were there living scatteredly here and there. Their language was one, but they were divided. That's why Serbian student killed by killing Francis Ferdinand. He wanted to communicate a message that Serbia would be united at any cost and no one would interrupt the way of unification of Serbia. So in order to communicate that message, one Serbian student killed Francis Ferdinand. So this group had been part of a larger underground movement. Who kills this person, Archduke Francis Ferdinand? This group known as the Black Hand. This group had been part of larger underground movement that was demanding the independence of the two predominantly Serbian provinces of Bosnia and Herzegovina from the Austro-Hungarian Empire. These are the most important two areas of territories. These were under the hands of the Austro-Hungarian Empire, but Serbian students wanted to get it back at hook or by coup. Now Austria accused the Serbian government. Since Austrian Princess Archduke Francis Ferdinand was assassinated, Austria accused Serbian government at Belgrade as being a part of the elaborate conspiracy to shake the Austro-Hungarian Empire. But Germany supported the Austrian government, Austrian claim, and the battle lines were drawn up. Austria sent an ultimatum to Serbia demanding dismissal of all officials sympathetic to the cause of Bosnia and independence and permission for Austrian officials to investigate in case of Serbia. That means there were some ultimatum. That ultimatum was served to Serbian government by Austria, but almost all their demands were accepted by Serbia except only one demand which affected their national integrity and sovereignty. That's why Serbia finally decided not to accept the last demand. So as per the ultimatum and as per the refusal of the last demand of Austria declared war on Serbia. As I mentioned earlier, that it was due to the support of Germany and it was due to the support of Russia. Both of the two powers met a war, and that war had become a part of the First World War. Other political powers, other countries of Europe, they all came forward to support the stand of Serbia and the stand for Austria. Austro-Hungarian Empire was required to be disintegrated, but Russia strongly supported Serbia on the question of breaking the Austro-Hungarian Empire, and ultimately Austria became an independent country and Hungary also later. But Serbia began to look for the allies and found one in Russia. And as Russia was alarmed at the idea of Austro-Hungarian Empire spreading its authority any further, and after the death of Archduke Ferdinand of Austria, heir to the throne of Austria, countries of Asia, Europe and Africa, they all became more and more conscious on the question of protecting their national integrity and sovereignty. As a result of it, the process of increasing power, the process of increasing military power and weapons had become more and more more and more important to them. That's why they gave priority in increasing their weapons, as a result sophisticated weapon, or as a result chemical weapons came. Chemical weapons, they started producing chemical weapons, and the prolonged war and the creation of trenches introduced new kind of chemical weapons. That's why it is said that First World War was a war where a dangerous weapon, a number of dangerous weapons were used by the countries of Europe and fought against each other with that weapons. As a result, huge number of official buildings, huge number of public buildings, roads, bridges, railway lines, government offices, these all were totally destroyed due to explosion, due to the sophisticated weapons used during the First World War. The Air Force and Navy, they battled both the Eastern and Western Front, also progressed very slowly. The focus shifted to other forms of warfare, and ultimately, as you know, it resulted in success. Only success for the for some such countries like England, like France, like Russia. But Russia supported Serbia, but it was the interest of Russia. Russia decided to support Serbia, but it was decided by Germany to support Austria, but it was in the interest of not only Austria but in the interest of herself. Germany decided to support the stand of Austria, but finally their main aim was to establish colonies. It was not a factor. The factor was establishing their own colonies in Far East, in Southeast Asia, by both Russia and Germany. And as a result, shooting down a flying enemy became another war hazard. The Germany decided to take the battle into civilian areas using U-boats or submarines to target all ships crossing the Atlantic. That's why Germany temporarily got advantages because of the U-boats they produced. The U-boats they made, it was the main intention of that U-boat was to disturb other countries' weapons, the other countries' boats, which generally would carry weapons, sophisticated weapons for their respective countries. So Germany decided to disturb this process of carrying weapons through U-boats. That's why Germany strengthened her naval power in order to disturb France, in order to disturb Britain, and in order to take advantages of the situation. So in order to avoid Germans conspiracy, Germans aspiration, Germans strategy, the three countries of Europe temporarily remained silent. They were France, England, and Russia. And Germany realized that these countries were adopting these countries already have adopted the policy of peaceful coexistence, but it was temporarily, it was adopted temporarily, and it was the part of their strategies. That's why Germany in course of time decided to strengthen her military power, and also Germany was able to establish more and more colonies throughout Europe, Asia, and ultimately it also paved the way of another paved the way of First World War. First World War took place because of the reason. More causes also are there behind it. I would like to discuss it in my next class. Thank you.